Janet Macklin was discovered with contusions, a mild concussion, a ruptured eardrum. Wouldn't you say that these were indications that she was a battered wife?
Or someone made to look that way.
By whom?
Herself?
In other words, she shot her husband and then threw herself down the stairs to make it look like self-defense.
Perhaps.
You're a very gifted lawyer, Mr. Holstrom.
Thank you.
Only a very gifted lawyer could convince a jury that Janet Macklin, without provocation, assaulted and severely crippled her husband for life.
Miss Ballin, try to imagine yourself in court with the complete text, not that abridged press version you keep referring to.
I have read the complete text. And isn't it a hard fact that Janet Macklin's husband could have attacked her first?
Her counsel pleaded self-defense and lost the case.
Her counsel was a 26-year-old public defender fresh out of law school.
He passed the bar.
Last year, this was his second case. But when wealthy
people... What the hell is she doing?
Nailing his ass.
Control the jobs of...
Q, 1 minute.
Q, one.
May I warn you that you are just on this side of being libelous?
Jesus
Christ.
Wouldn't
you say that it would be more ethical to move the trial to a different town?
On camera two?
In certain cases, a change of venue might be...
Would you be prepared to discuss the case next week with her new lawyer?
I didn't know she had one.
Yes, as of 3:15 this afternoon, William Kraft Davies has accepted this case. A fund has been started for her defense, which I, for one, would be the first to contribute.
Are you nuts? Huh?
Listen, I feel good about what I did.
You put that bastard on trial.
He should be on trial.
Your job is not to take sides.
What is my job? All that I did was to give somebody an even break.
Deb. You're wrong, you know.
I am right. Listen, I need fuel if I'm going to fight. Let's eat, huh? Let's eat. Come on.
I'm going to make you pay for the little.
Got a call, Francine.
Dumb. I hate grandstanding. It ain't professional.
Shh. Francine, you got back okay? Oh, good. Listen, the living room's getting a little gamey.
Oh.
There's liquor on the car. I'm not asking you to scrub the carpet, just clear out some glasses, okay? She thinks she's a house guest. Look, I'm not gonna be home for dinner. I will. But.
Why don't you fire her?
I'm getting close.
Deborah, I can't put that on the air.
So angry. Don't get close.
You admit you're wrong, you still can't see my side?
Oh, come on.
Well, let's talk about it over dinner. Now, let me take you home.
I'm not going home, I want to walk.
Now, wait a minute. All right, walk.
Francine?
Ah.
shit. I give up. I give up. I want you to clean up this mess before you leave tonight. Your own bed. That's it. That's it. Thank you.
Missed it by a few centimeters. Tore up the muscle ball pretty badly, though.
What about the other x-rays?
Got a nasty open fracture of the humerus.
We may have to go in there.
You really messed her up? Could you stand an operation?
Not yet.
Colt! I'm glad you're back. Guess what's on? Murder on the Limited. I just play a small part. It's one of the first films I ever did with Monogram. I looked for my letter in the Times this morning, but of course they didn't print it. Well, I know how you're always writing letters to people, and you're right, you know. Nobody listens. I got a form letter from my congressman one time. So shy.
Yeah, well, you can add murder to that lady, just don't get me too mad.
Center here in the city, and they're devoted to interpersonal communication, fulfilling our human potential and sensory constraints. Doctor, your motto is get in touch with yourself by touching others.
Yeah.
Now, what sort of needs do you fulfill at the center?
Intimacy, really. We're living in an alienated society where people have forgotten how to touch. They've forgotten how to be intimate with one another. And at the Institute, we teach an important form of the expression. Repressed hostility is often expressed in covert prejudice or overt violence.
Or both?
Yes.
And do you feel that touch therapy acts as safe enough?
Without relief, there is an implosion. Scattered gutter.
You're at County General Hospital.
Dry.
You feel well enough to talk? The police are here. I'll make sure they keep it brief.
How bad is it?
You're fine. The doctor will explain. You've got a lot of friends, or else you know a lot of florists. I know.
Give me a second.
Sure.
Oh, my face. Do you have a mirror? Do you have a mirror? My face isn't... Perfect.
You look fine.
No, I don't. But why should I? Send in the clowns.
Gentlemen.
Thank you.
Just 5 minutes.
Mrs. Ballin, this won't take long.
I can tell you right now, I don't remember much.
I've just started a new rating system.
Huh?
You know that young resident? The one I went out with, Dr. Harvey.
Mm.
He gets a 2. It's a new low. Surprising bad.
It's better than laughing.
A 901 and 907 ready.
On our way. Come on.
Come on.
He actually cries in bed. Don't ask me why. I turned down the lights, and we started to make love. And he starts whimpering. It's crazy. He's an obstetrician.
Well, hang on to him. I think you're going to need him.
Nurse Humble's free up. Nurse Humble's free up.
Connie, don't let that book get in the wrong hands, eh?
Under the circumstances.
I don't look too bad. Take the good one.
You know what I'm thinking?
We hadn't had a fight. This never would have happened.
Right.
Did you see what he did? Francine.
I know.
Bastard. The bastard. Why didn't he just take what he wanted and leave? Why did he?
He's just crazy.
What's that?
Some intensive care equipment.
For me?
For you or anyone who needs it. Deborah Bellin, 9th floor. You can take them right up, and could you take this up with you, please?
Telephone call for Dr. Michael. Telephone call for Dr. Michael.
Say, are you an orderly? Will somebody take me to the launch?
Here he is. Mr. Delaney, for God's sake. Come on.
No, I'm going to be late. Well, I wanted to keep an eye on Deborah Bellin. She suffered an awful lot after what that bastard did to her. I don't know. What? Oh, God knows. But whoever did ought to be caged and fed raw meat. Anyway, I've appointed myself sort of an official watchdog. Keep the visitors away, screen the press, and help out with the Janet Macklin thing, stuff like that. Yeah, well, I'll be home after the second shift. It won't be too late. Okay, say goodnight to the kids. Thanks. Fancy restaurants. Don't go with interns. Oh, it's Mrs. Corrigan.
I don't want fancy, but a coffee shop, for God's sake. I could have died. I'm wearing a cocktail dress, and he takes me to a coffee shop.
Then why'd you rate him a 6?
Dinner was a 1, but he was a 5.
Oh, Connie.
Was that?
Oh, Faye Marcus.
Not again. Look, you must be exhausted. I'll take the long walk.
Oh, thank you. This double shift is gonna kill me.
Picture, it's an x-ray. Okay, that'll have to do.
A woman must always look her very best at all times. She must keep her partner.
Good night, Mrs. Marcus.
No matter where they are or what they're doing.
Nightmare.
Well, it's not surprising after what happened to you. I'm sorry we had to move you. There was an emergency. Here. Is your room okay?
Oh, it's quiet.
Hope you can identify him, eh?
Oh, I don't know. Maybe it really was the delivery man.
But it all happened
so fast.
Look, I'll send someone with you, okay? Just...
No, that won't be necessary.
No, I think it's better.
I'll be all right. Thank you. back to sleep, sweetheart. Okay.
Frankly, I'm a mess.
Oh, would you mind babysitting for me tomorrow, too?
Hi, Cole. Would you like to do something someday? Like, go to a movie, maybe, or something?
Yeah, sure.
Christ, you really blast them all, don't you? Blacks, Jews, Mexicans. You want the whole goddamn world to yourself?
Yeah. Yeah, I'd like that.
I like noise. Hey, just a minute.
Take them off.
Yeah, sure. What's in here anyway? Oh, you scared the shit out of me.
Take them off. Please. Come here.
Easy. I can't breathe. Please. Please, let go! No!
No. You want TV?
Yeah. Let's go ask him.
How about noise? You want noise? You got noise. Want anything else? How about this? You like this? Mm-hmm.
Do you think the robbery and assault on you is in any way related to one of your editorials, or is it only coincidental?
Well, when people are angry, they send me letters. They get their feelings out on paper, not on me. I mean, if everybody acted on their threats, there'd be a murderer on every block.
How do you handle hate mail?
I don't read it.
In answer to your question, we don't think there's any connection.
With your boss's cooperation, we've just screened tonight's editorial on the Janet Macklin case. Are you going to make it for the second interview?
If they have to wheel me in, I will make it.
Has your stand on nonviolence been altered as a result of your attack?
I don't think that when I said that I was thinking of one person's violence against another person. I think I was,
thinking in world terms.
It sounds as though your hard line on violence has softened.
No.
Boy.
Miss Ballin's position remains the same. Self-defense is our only protection against violence, but self-defense doesn't mean one is pro-violence.
You feel that the courts are the only self-defense we have?
No, but self-defense doesn't mean bearing arms.
Would you have a gun in your house?
No.
Since the courts are shackled with laws...
Mummy's gone. Do you understand?
...be ignoring the victim, what would you do?
Oh, start acknowledging the victim. Protection agencies have started springing up in every...
I don't know where she is.
Trial delays have caused cases to be dropped, and in many instances, convicted criminals are now out on bond.
I brought your father his tea.
What is your feeling about that?
Frustration, but one of the things that we must live with.
Where did he get this?
I found it in the closet. I put it out. It seemed to please him.
Anger.
Leave us.
We're going to have to wrap this up.
One last question.
Okay.
Have a nice drink. Oh, don't put your hand up. You can't get a drink with a hand up like that. Now, hold still. Here comes another drink for you, Colt. Oh, wait a minute. Another drink.
That for me? Hey, I'm the one having surgery.
Yeah.
I thought you were off today.
I am. I'm just filling in for a couple of hours.
Have fun.
Thanks.
Taking the kids out?
Yes. Right to my ex-husband's. He has them through Labor Day.
Have a workout.
I will. It's a good idea.
This morning.
Oh, it's so good to get out. I'm going to take these to the lady who's in my old room.
Oh, why don't you let me do that for you?
No. I want to visit.
Hello.
Hello. Hello. Is this the right room? Sorry.
I'm Vincent Bradshaw. My friends call me Vinny.
Hiya, Vinny.
Read about what happened to you. Damn shame. Hey, I bet you're looking for a story in there.
Where?
931.
Why?
Well, I hear they found an old lady. Murdered.
Mr. Bradshaw, what are you doing out of your room? You promised.
I'm just stretching my legs. See, I hear we're going under the knife at the same time. We'll pull together. I'm in the room next to yours.
Why didn't you tell me about that woman?
What woman?
What woman? Oh, boy. They really have gotten to you. Oh. What's this?
Please,
what
Ms.
is this?
Bowen.
Look, I have told you I am checking out of here. Have I made myself clear?
What's going on?
We have a little problem here.
Why didn't you tell me about that woman? Why didn't you tell me about that woman? That woman in my old room.
He killed her.
He thought it was me. I know it. Listen. That was not a robbery in my house. It is me he's after. I know it. Why didn't you tell me? I thought I could trust you.
Deborah, you can trust me, but there are rules. I have to follow them, and you're my patient.
He thought it was me. It is me he is after.
We don't know that. All they know for sure is that she was very wealthy. She has a lot of relatives.
What are you talking about?
Deborah, if you want to do your show on the 25th, you have to have surgery.
No!
Please,
God damn it! Damn it! Damn it!
It's only Demerol. It'll relax you. Please trust me.
Damn.
It'll be fine.
Damn. Damn Halls. He's here. I know it.
I'll be gone for a few hours, but I'll be back to check on you later.
Don't leave me. He's here. I know it.
What are you doing here? You're not on surgical staff. Get out of here.
Thank you.
Please, would you mind staying for a few more days to help me out for your vacation?
Sure, that way I don't have to go home first.
Ah, devious. Now where's Bridget?
She's probably hiding again.
He's faking.
I'll go hunt her.
No, that's all right. I'll find her.
She isn't really sick.
Cool it, Buster. Bridget! Bridget!
Don't be a bad girl today.
Sweetheart, you don't have to do this.
I don't feel good.
Come here. You win. You can stay with Denise. I'm gonna go to the clinic for a couple of hours, but I'll be back.
She gets to stay.
Because she has a temperature.
My stomach hurts.
Right. Come on,
car.
Watch your fingers.
Deborah Ballin, a staunch defender of Janet Maclin, is also a professed advocate of nonviolence. Ms. Ballin has recently been brutally attacked herself, and this reporter wonders if, instead of defending Maclin on a platform of civil liberties, Ms. Ballin will now defend her violent act as a reasonable form of self-defense. Will she join the thousands of American women who feel it is time to learn how to fight back?
No! Dad!
I'm warning you. I'm warning you!
You didn't hear a thing I said.
You said you thought you heard him in the surgery room, but here you are looking very much the worse for wear.
I know, but what about that woman who was in my room? What about that nurse? What about...
She's probably knocked up by some relative.
Don't say that. Jesus!
Honey, look. They got a great security system here. Everybody's screened who comes in. They got cops all over the place. There's a guard outside the door.
You know.
The reaction to the show was terrific. There'll be editorials, gonna be publicity. The public is backing you, it's fantastic. So, concentrate on that.
How much more damage is there?
A lot, I'm sore all over.
How did it happen?
I walked into a door.
And you don't wanna give his name? Lisa. This isn't your first time to the free clinic?
No. I haven't seen you here before.
I come in one day a week.
Oh, see how the other half lives, huh?
My dear, there is no other half. I don't see anything here I don't see at the hospital.
Where do you work?
County General.
The That understanding look isn't going to be followed by some advice by any chance.
I didn't listen. Why should you?
Oh, really rough, was it? Wore your corsage on the wrong side to the prom?
I missed my prom. I was pregnant. I'm working nights with my husband.
No way he chewed me up so bad, because he couldn't make it.
You're lucky. You walked in this time.
Well, he won't get away with it.
So you think Janet Macklin was assaulted first?
My first husband beat the hell out of me. It took a whole year for my jaw to heal properly.
Would you have shot him if you'd had a gun?
You gotta protect yourself. It's gotten crazy.
Yes, but not for very long. It was like 3 years in a war zone.
Do you think men are afraid of you?
Oh, God, I hope not.
I mean, because of your stand on women's rights.
Well, it's not just women's rights. It's people. It's their rights. That's all there is people. I can't get too emotional over a car wreck. It's the people inside that matter.
I admire the hell out of you.
I'm always prepared for a battle. I'm never prepared for a compliment. Thank you.
Bachelor to room 916. Well, do it. Now.
She's a real bitch, eh? Gallstones. Too much loose living. I really think it was worth it, though. Hey, you must be new here. 916's down the other end. That's Joe Barriga's room. It's a good pal of mine, you know? Bleeding ulcers. Is that real gold? Smart investment. Got 20% of my worth in gold, just as a hedge against a calamity or something. Just went over here. Come on in, join the party.
you kill. I'm dying. I think I'm dying. You didn't want to get dirty, did you, huh? Didn't think your mama wanted you dirty. Well, look at that. There you go, all over you.
No! Dan, I'm warning you. No! I'm warning you!
I want to go home.
You developed a mild infection. That's why they put that thing in you.
I am not hearing things, God damn it! I want to go to the window. I need some air.
You're gonna catch pneumonia.
Don't say anything, please. I'm right where he wants me.
I'm not gonna let anything happen to you. Do you understand?
Who is that? Who?
Security.
Okay.
with Sheila. Come on. Hold me. Hold me. Hold me. Breathe. Breathe.
Please, don't cry. Here. Pull yourself together. It's gonna be all right. You okay?
Checking into that place, sir.
A minute, for God's sakes.
You know how many people are dead because of me?
Not because of you, because of him. Don't do that to yourself. We found the place he escaped from. It's been sealed off.
What's going on in there? This place isn't sealed. He's in. He's out.
For God's sake.
Hey,
you
gotta
be on that IV. Will you come here? Come here.
Come
here. Will you sit down?
Why is he after me?
Because you're a strong woman. You're independent. Capable of making decisions. Decisions that sway public opinion. You make a lot of people angry, Debbie.
What did I say? What did I say? What did I do?
It's the Janet Macklin thing. That's why the big push. He doesn't want you to make that second interview.
Why doesn't he go after her?
Because you're telling America that she's right, and you're telling your sick mind that he's wrong. You're the focus, not her. You've triggered a psychopath.
I want to go home now.
You can't. I'm going to stay with you all night. And in the morning, I'll quietly get you out.
Okay. Sheila?
I'm not budging.
You just got your third page.
I know, but I...
Someone downstairs is pretty anxious to see you.
All right. Donna... Brush these into Deborah Ballin's room.
You may serve my breakfast right here.
Long distance phone call for Dr. Martin. Long distance phone call for Dr. Martin.
Hi.
What are you doing here?
I had to see you, and I remember you said you worked here.
Should we never? You'll want to see another bouncing?
Hey, you.
It's all right. I know.
Okay.
Are you all right?
Have a seat.
Showing required in room 901.
I think you should see these. Where did you get these?
Colt, the asshole that messed me up. I said he'd pay for what he did. Well, me and a couple of friends redecorated his apartment. But those were on the wall inside his closet. And some other ones, too.
You know where he lives?
Yeah.
Come on.
Oh, wait a minute. I brought the pictures. I mean, that's it. Look, lady, you're lucky to be alive. He's killed someone.
Sheila, telephone for you.
Take a message.
Maybe you should take it. Sounds strange.
Hello?
Who is this?
Who is this?
What is it? Allen's room. It's 903 and given to Gary Baylor and to the police officer that's with him, and tell them I had to rush home.
Where do you think you're going?
Deborah Ballin's room, 903.
Are you registered?
No.
Sir, listen, I just got a phone call. I think it may be the man that you're looking for. Can you please?
Officer.
Get someone.
The lady needs help.
Yeah, what is it?
Look, I just got a phone call. I think it's the man
hey,
that you're
hey,
looking
hey,
for.
Hey, hold on.
Here,
slowly.
My daughter. Can you please just come with me?
Lady,
I need
I'm on duty. I can't.
Can you call someone or do...
Lady, if you'll just explain to me
what
it's all...
Forget it.
Lady.
Those are my orders. I can't let you in there. I'm sorry, miss. Put it away, please, and go home. Why don't you phone the hospital? No, I'm sorry, miss. No. Hey, you! Come with me.
It's about fucking well time.
Take her to 903.
Oh, Mr. Pine, give me a break. Now look, just hang on here for a sec. I'll just get this patient settled.
upstairs until I call you. Keep quiet. Mr. Baylor, it's Sheila. Would you put Miss Ballin on? Deborah?
Thank you. How's she doing?
The blade cracked her rib, but probably saved her life.
The girl that was killed 2 weeks ago. She's got a whole assortment in there.
Fight him, Howard.
Jesus Christ. What the hell is this?
Stand back. Look at that. He's created a death mask. Get out of
here. Just rest now. If you need anything, press this buzzer.
Enough tonight. Cops have caused a real panic.
I'd still feel more secure.
The board's buzzing now with cops up here.
You're going to listen to me. You wanted me to make it. You never listen. Talking, talking all the time. You're going to listen to me. You feel me through this, huh? What? No, you don't.
Where is he?
Oh, hasn't he been put through enough? Where's your warrant?
Where is he?
We'll take care of this.
He hurt himself. We had to call an ambulance.
What?
Yeah. They took him to County General Hospital.
Right, guys, come on, let's go.
I want every man to feel
on the ninth floor.
On the ninth floor, let's go.
Come on, elevator.
Clear the elevators, please.
Every now.
Clear the
elevator.
Chest X-ray now.
It's locked up tighter than the Vatican down there. Not even any cops.
Well, get Grayson to open it. She needs X-rays.
Okay, let's go.
Technician's having coffee. Get him fast.
Sealing off the second floor. They must be working their way down.
He'll slip through.
Ow! Ow!
doing here?
Get help. Call the security guard. Call him. Here. Here.